Thank you for joining me for this power yoga practice. My name is Tamara Maxim, if we haven't met before. And I'm really thrilled to share these practices with you online through Facebook and then uploading them to my YouTube channel. So if you're joining on Facebook and you want to check out more videos, I have more than 100 of them in different styles, ranging from 5-minute meditations in nature all the way to 90-minute classes in styles for adults and for kids, and you can look it up under my name, Tamara Maxim. And if you like music for your yoga practice, I have a Spotify channel under Tamara YVR, and you can choose really any of the playlists. They're all appropriate for yoga classes, depending whether you like more upbeat music or more relaxing music, so you can listen to them and find ones that you like. Today, our practice will focus on the Hanuman pose, the splits pose, and Hanuman is a character in Hindu mythology that has amazing stories associated with him. What I really like about Hanuman are the qualities that he represents, which are loyalty and friendship and devotion. He was willing to take great leaps of faith in dedication to a friend and do whatever it took to be supportive and caring and loving. And when he was called to action, he didn't even hesitate. He just went right for it. And I think in all of us, we have those same qualities. And through our yoga practice, we can learn to harness that same energy of loyalty, of dedication, of being willing to jump to action when called upon, and bring that into the rest of our life. So we'll do that today through our practice. So take a few moments to sit up nice and tall. You can sit on your shin bones like I'm sitting in this variation of Virasana, or you can sit cross-legged. Let your spine become long. Get focused and centered. And just take a moment to let your breath come to an even place. Not sure what you've done so far in your day today, but could have been really active, or maybe you're just getting going. And wherever you are, identify where the breath is in your body and see if you can bring it more toward the heart. The heart is where the story of Hanuman really rests, and this idea of bhakti or devotion. If you like, you can bring to mind some people in your life that you feel very devoted to, that you hold in your heart, that you send loving kindness to, that you care about. And if you like, you can dedicate this practice to them. Feel free to bring in a word or a phrase or a mantra that will help you to keep that energy of Hanuman contained, that energy of that immediate call to action, that ability to jump into it, to take that leap of faith, to give all that you can for the people that you love. And then if you like, float your hands to your heart center and connect there with your breath and your heart at the same time. See if you can lift your heart to be a little closer toward your thumbs. Let the energy of your heart shine a little brighter. We'll take 3 deep clearing breaths, and then the 4th breath will be for Om. Deep inhale through your nose. Sigh out your mouth. Inhale through your nose. Sigh out your mouth. One more like that. Deep inhale. The next breath for Om. Deep inhale. Om. Letting the reverberation and echo of that Om, that sacred sound, connect to your own internal vibration, the nada. Let it stay with you through the practice, that echo of peace and harmony carried with you. And then when you're ready, make your way onto your back. And I'll be doing this class along with you as a demonstration. So if you're not sure what to do, just take a look at me. You can always take a rest in a child pose, a tabletop, or even lie down onto your back. So pace yourself as you like. Lying down onto your back, hug your knees into your chest. Give yourself a nice big squeeze. Maybe rock a little bit side to side. And then lower your left foot to the floor. Extend your right heel up toward the ceiling and hold behind your hamstring. So right below the knee, somewhere in the deeper meat of the hamstring. See if you can press your heel straight up to the ceiling and press your hamstring into your hands as you pull the hands into the hamstring. So there's a bit of traction there. And then if it feels okay, you can release your left leg to the floor and create an L shape with your legs. Keep pressing up into that heel, pressing the hamstring toward the hands, pulling the hands toward the hamstring. And this is the part of the body that requires us to have that unyielding dedication and loyalty in our practice. It can be very resistant to lengthening. So we have to give it a lot of love and dedication. And then from here, bend your knee in toward your chest. Give yourself a squeeze and see if you can hold on either to your big toe, to the outside of your foot, or even behind your hamstring, and pull your knee to the right side. So wherever you're holding on, pull your knee down to the right side, a half happy baby. If you need to, you can always bend your left knee and place your foot on the floor. Then rock a little bit to the side, so that left foot or left leg might come off the mat. Rock a little bit side to side. Get an opening into the groin area, the inner thigh. And then coming to a place of rest, see if you can start to extend that leg. So making a really long shape with your legs here, even if your left knee is bent, see if you can pull that right foot out to the right and even back toward the top corner of your mat. If it's comfortable for you, you can knee that left thigh down, trying to get the back of the thigh down to the mat, pressing out through your left heel. And then soften your knees, come back through center, give yourself a little squeeze, and we'll go to the other side. So you can bring your left knee in toward your chest. You can keep your right knee bent, right foot on the floor. Extend your leg. To move something out of the way here. Extend your leg. Pulling that left knee back behind you. And you can stay here if this is okay for you, if this is enough. Or holding on behind the thigh. Or maybe big toe lock, that Parangustasana grip. Or wrapping your hand around the outer left foot. And then pull that knee down. And again, that right knee can bend, your foot can stay on the floor. You can keep that right heel extending out, pressing the back of your right leg down. And then from here, try to extend your left leg to any degree, pulling not only your leg just straight, but maybe pulling your toes back behind you to the top of your mat. You can use that right hand on the top of your right thigh to knead the thigh down. Try to extend through the back of your leg, pressing out through your heel. Getting that opening in the inner groin, the thigh. Coming back through center, hug your knees in toward your chest. And we'll take happy baby here, so a full happy baby, wrapping your hands around the outer edges of your feet, elbows on the inside. And as you curl your tailbone down toward the mat away from you, press your hands into your feet, feet into your hands, and let your knees come up wide and down. And then from here, if you like, Supta Upavishta Konasana, letting your legs extend straight, and maybe even wrapping your hands on the inside arches of your feet and pulling your toes down toward the mat, or the outer edges of your mat, as you roll your tailbone down. And then gathering everything back in. And since we're here on our back, perfect time to do a little bit of core work. So again, hugging the knees in, extend both legs up toward the ceiling. Try to keep your legs as straight as you can. So flexing out through the heels, a soft bend to your knees, not to hyperextend the knees. Taking your fingertips beside your ears, draw the belly in toward your spine. Try to flatten your lower back. Take an inhale. And as you exhale, lift your head and shoulders up. Now on your next inhale breath, reach your right arm toward the outside of your left ankle and lower your right heel to the floor. Stay here, a little pulse, and you can pulse with both arms if you like. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Come back through center, both feet together, then lower your left foot down. Take an inhale, reach your left arm past your right leg,
And we'll pulse. You can use both arms, hovering that left heel. 8, 7, belly in. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Back through center. Reach both hands towards your feet. Draw the belly in. Take an inhale breath as you exhale. Lift everything up. Lift your hips up. Lift your shoulders up. And we'll start to go side to side. So drop your right heel. Right hand comes to the outside of your left leg. You can keep your left fingertips beside your ear if you like. And then switch. So left hand to the outside of your right leg. And let's keep going. For 10, 9, 8, 7. Keeping those legs straight. 5. Pressing out through the heel. 3, 2, and 1. And hug everything in. Give yourself that nice squeeze. Now holding behind the thighs, start to rock forward and back a few times. And we'll make our way through a tabletop position all the way to downward dog. So you can hop it or step it or anything you like to get back there. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward dog. Spreading your fingertips wide. Make sure your index finger is pointing straight ahead. And imagine you're palming a basketball with your hand. So there's a pressing forward and down of the finger pads. But there's a bit of a doming underneath the knuckles in the center of the palm. You can keep your knees soft and focus on lengthening your hips away from your hands to get that spine long. And then when you're ready over time, maybe not today, pressing down through your heels, letting the legs lengthen. Maybe your heels will touch, maybe they won't. And let your head be heavy here. Maybe you're looking between your inner thighs or even curling more with chin toward the chest. Try to create some space as you draw the eye of the elbows toward each other. Take one more deep inhale here. Stay for your exhale. Then on your inhale breath, come high in your toes. Bend your knees a lot. Look forward. Walk, step, or hop to the top of your mat. Using that core strength to float. Ardha Uttanasana, halfway lift. Palms to shins for the first one or fingers in front of your toes. Exhale, Uttanasana, fold. Press down through your feet to rise. Urdhva Hastasana. Curl the tailbone toward your heels. Palms touch as you arch back. Exhale, hands to heart center. Samasthitihi. On your inhale breath, reach up and back. Urdhva Hastasana. Back bend if you like. Exhale, fold forward. Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen. Flat back. Ardha Uttanasana. As you exhale, plant your palms. Walk, step, or hop back. Either high plank or Chaturanga Dandasana. Untuck your toes for a back bend, Cobra or Urdhva Mukha Svanasana if you're ready. Roll back over your toes, high plank. If you like, here, one Chaturanga push-up. And then all the way back and up, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Couple of deep breaths here, pressing your finger pads down. Create a bit of dome under those hands. Spine is lengthening, legs are lengthening. One more deep breath here, finding that Ujjayi breath as you exhale. Come high on your toes, bend your knees a lot, look forward. Walk, step, or hop. Try to find that float, halfway lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, release, Uttanasana. Inhale to rise, Urdhva Hastasana. We'll do one more set, Surya Namaskar, Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lengthen, flat back, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, palms flat down, Chaturanga Dandasana. You can lower halfway or all the way. Untuck your toes, Cobra or Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. If you like this optional Chaturanga from high plank, push right back, downward facing dog. Take a full breath in and a full breath out. One more, inhale. Exhale, Ujjayi breath. Come high on your toes, bend your knees, look forward. Walk, step, or hop. Halfway lift, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Inhale to rise, stay standing. Back bend if you like. And hands to heart center. Samasthitihi. And hands down by your side. On your inhale breath, with your big toes touching or feet hip distance apart, sit down low. Try to sweep your fingertips back behind you. Grip the mat with your index fingers and see if you can pull your tailbone towards your heels to engage Mulabandha, the root lock.
And then keeping the core strong, keep the center of your belly pressing toward your spine, Uddiyana Bandha. And reach your arms up to the sky, finding Utkatasana, chair pose. See if you can hug the outer thighs toward each other, pull your kneecaps back so you could see your big toes, and sit a little deeper, so you're like a lightning bolt. Take one more inhale here, lift your chest a little higher. Stay for your exhale. One more breath, reach up. And as you exhale, lift your hips and fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, lengthen, flat back, Ardha Uttanasana. As you exhale, plant your palms, Chaturanga Dandasana. Take a back bend for a full breath in. If you like, high plank, Chaturanga, and all the way back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Take a full breath in as you reach your right leg up to the sky. As you exhale, stack your hip, bend your knee, let your foot drop behind you to get a little thigh opener here. And then inhale, stretch that leg back behind you, big extension through your heel. As you exhale, bring your knee in toward your chest. Keep coming forward, rock forward even more, lift the knee a little higher, maybe forehead towards your knee. Then step your right foot quietly through inside your right thumb. Back heel spins down. Your feet are hip distance apart. Arms are reaching up. Virabhadrasana 1. Pull your outer right hip back, left thigh forward, lunge into your front knee. On your inhale breath, get a little longer through your side body. As you exhale, interlace your hands behind your lower back. Try to close your hands tight together. Keep them that way. On your inhale breath, lengthen your knuckles toward the earth, chest to the sky. As you exhale, bow forward over your front thigh, Baddha Virabhadrasana. Let your shoulder rest on the top of your right thigh, or maybe it dips down, so the crown of your head is working toward the inside of your right foot. Hands are squeezing tight together, center of the shoulder blade squeezing. Let your head be heavy. Take one more inhale breath, lift your hands up a little higher, close your hands tight together, keeping your right hip pulling back. Stay for your exhale. Then on your inhale, pull yourself back up, release your arms to the sky. As you exhale, plant your hands down, step that left foot back just a little bit so you're high on your toes. Sweep your right leg back, keep it floating if you can, Chaturanga Dandasana. Both feet down for your back bend. Making your way all the way back, extra Chaturanga if you like, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Take an inhale breath, left leg sweeps to the sky, stack your hip, bend your knee, open it up. Get that thigh stretch, let your foot drop behind you. One more inhale here. Then as you exhale, bring your knee in toward your chest. Come high on those back toes, lift your hips, pull your forehead toward your knee, knee to the forehead, belly in. One more inhale, rock forward more, and then step through. Back heel down, feet hip distance apart, and rise up. Keeping those heels hip distance, pull your left hip back, right thigh forward, lunge deeply into that front knee. Keeping that length through your spine, take an inhale here, bend a little deeper as you exhale, Virabhadrasana 1. On your inhale breath, float the hands to the lower back, see if you can find that opposite grip. Might be the more unnatural grip, if you took your natural grip the first time. Again, keeping those knuckles and hands tight together, squeeze your shoulder blades, lengthen the arms the best you can. Heart lifts, knuckles down. And then as you exhale, you bow, Baddha Virabhadrasana. Pull your left hip back, right thigh forward. So you're not turning to the right. Your head is coming toward the inside of your front foot. And the more you drop your head, and the more you squeeze your shoulder blades and hands together, the more your hands will lift up over the head. Maybe one day your head will touch right down. One more deep inhale, stay for the exhale, and strong through the feet, pull yourself all the way back up, stabilize as you reach for the sky. As you exhale, hands come down, pop your right toes back to come high on your toes, sweep your left leg back, keep it floating if you can, find Chaturanga Dandasana, and then both feet down, take a back bend, stretch the belly, optional Chaturanga here. Adho Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Taking a full deep breath in and a full deep breath out. One more inhale and exhale.
bringing your toes together. Maybe walk a little closer to your hands. Come high on your toes, bend your knees. Walk step or hop, try to get that nice float, that quiet landing. Halfway lift, lengthen, look forward. Fold as you release, exhale. Chair pose, feet touching if you like. Hips down, reach your arms up. And this time bring your hands to your heart center. Lean forward as you take a breath in. As you exhale, twist to the right side. Hook your left elbow outside your right knee. You might notice that your left knee comes further forward, so pull it back with your hip. If you like, tent your fingertips. Create space between your hands, creating strong fingers that are good for balancing. As you press your top fingers into your bottom fingers, twist a little deeper. Maybe sit your hips lower. Maybe you open your arms. Left fingers down, right arm up. Take one more full breath here. Stay for your exhale. Then on your inhale, stay in chair. Stay dedicated. Stay loyal to yourself. Stay in the center, hands to your heart. Lean forward. Twist to the left. You might notice that right knee pop forward, so pull it back. Tent your fingertips if you can. Pressing top into bottom, twist a little deeper. Sitting your hips lower. Take a couple deep breaths here, twisting around the spiral of your spine. Then maybe your right fingertips come down, left come up, keep sitting low. One more inhale, stay for your exhale. And now inhale, come back to chair, even if you want to get up. And then lift your hips and fold, such a nice reward. Inhale, lengthen, flat back, Ardha Uttanasana. As you exhale, plant your palms, walk, step, or hop back, Chaturanga, Dandasana. Take your back bend, heart open, chest lifting. Extra Chaturanga right here if you have it, and all the way back. On your inhale breath, lift your right leg up to the sky. This time, bring your right knee to your right upper arm, and if it's available to you, that same shape we did, try to extend your right leg out. If you have Kundanyasana B, of course, you can go for it. Inhale, sweep it back up. As you exhale, cross to the left upper arm and extend your right leg all the way through. Push it to the top corner and reach your left arm up, fall in triangle. Inhale, back through center. Try not to drag your right foot. Sweep it up. Exhale, bring in toward the chest, knee toward your nose. Inhale here. This time, step through to the center. Back heel spins down, front heel to back arch alignment, and you rise. Virabhadrasana 2. Wiggle your front toes forward more so you can get deeper into that front thigh and extend through your arms. Let your heart be open. Be dedicated and loyal to yourself in this posture, so don't wait to get into it. Get right into it. That call to action, it's immediate response. Deep full breath in, deep full breath out. On your inhale, flip your right palm, exalted warrior, pull it back. Stay here for a couple breaths. Maybe you bind your head, maybe you turn your chest open, maybe your left hand travels to the right thigh, or maybe your hands meet behind your heart. Wherever you are, keep lunging, lifting the chest, opening your heart. Big breath in. And a big breath out. Unwind as you breathe in. Take an inhale here. Straighten your front leg. Exhale back into it. Inhale, lean forward. As you're ready, forearm to thigh. Top arm reaches up and over your ear. Uttita Parsva Konasana. If you have the space, right fingertips down. Spin your left pinky down, thumb up. Look under your arm. Stay. Or spiral that left hand behind you. Half bind, or maybe right arm as well, underneath you, and find your left fingers or your left wrist with your right hand. Spin your chest open, either variation, bind or no bind, pulling your right hip back, spiraling that left inner thigh open, maybe looking up. And then look down, rise all the way back up, warrior two, straighten your front leg, and back into it. On your inhale, both hands come down to the mat. Lift your back heel. Step your right foot back to float. Chaturanga Dandasana. Both feet down. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, make your way back. Variation of chaturanga here, and then all the way back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Deep full breath in, deep full breath out.
Inhale, left leg lifts to the sky. As you exhale, left knee to left upper arm. Now pause here and hold, or try extending that leg, that same kind of split shape we started with. Maybe Kundanyasana B if you have it. Inhale, sweep it back up. And cross to the right side. Thread that left leg all the way through. Try to push it up to the top corner of your mat, past your mat. Reach your right arm up, fall in triangle. And then both hands are down. Try not to drag your left leg as you take it back. Exhale, knee comes in toward your chest. Keep coming forward, forehead to knee. Step through in the center. Back heel spins down, front heel to back arch alignment this time. Virabhadrasana 2. Open it up. And again, that devotion, that bhakti, that call to action for those we love. Don't hesitate here. Get right into it. Sit deeper, opening your heart, reaching forward and back, gazing forward. Channeling that same quality of loyalty, of devotion, of dedication that Hanuman has. On your next inhale, left palm flips up, right hand down, pull your left hand back. Keep lunging into that left knee. We have a few breaths, so if you like, guide the hand behind your head. Turn your heart open. Maybe right hand spirals around. Maybe both hands meet behind the heart. But sometimes we tend to come out of the pose. Get in even deeper. Spin your chest open, lift your heart, breathe in. And breathe out fully. One more. Coming back to Warrior Two, straighten your front leg as you breathe in. Bend your knee as you breathe out. Then on your inhale breath, as you're ready, left forearm to left thigh, sweep that top arm over your ear, pinky finger down, thumb up. You can stay here. Maybe your left fingertips come down inside of your left foot. You can also spiral that right hand behind you. Maybe it comes to the top of your thigh. Maybe you have the full bind, left arm underneath. Maybe you can wrap your fingers together or your left fingers around your right wrist. And then turn the heart open so you're not curling forward. The crown of your head in line with your front toes. Big breaths here. Open the heart. And as you're ready, look down, unwind yourself, come all the way back up. Straighten your front leg as you breathe in. Bend your front knee as you breathe out. On your inhale, both hands down to the mat. Lift your left leg back behind you, Chaturanga Dandasana. Take your breath in, back bend. And take your breath out, making your way back, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Deep full inhale. Deep full exhale. Stepping your toes together to touch. Come high on your toes. Bend your knees a lot, and we're going to hop through to a squat where our toes are together behind our hands. Big breath in, and when you're ready, a little slight squat. Taking your hands slightly forward, spread your fingertips wide again. That same sensation of palming a basketball. So how widely can you spread your hands? How much can you grip down with your finger pads? Get that sensation of feeling grounded and connected. And keeping your toes touching, press into the hands, try to lengthen your legs and come high on your toes. And you might need to step back just a little bit, but keep those legs, toes connected. Press down into the hands and see if you can rock forward. The shoulders even coming past the wrist creases. That idea of the handstand, pressing down into the hands. And then from here, working into Kakasana Crow Pose, take your knees out wide without separating your toes and bend your elbows back until they meet together. Right at the point where your knees are behind your upper arms. And hug the belly in tight. Adjust your hands maybe closer to your feet if you need, but keep them slightly outer shoulder distance apart. And then rocking forward. Take your time here. Without actively lifting your feet, can you rock forward? Keep rocking forward. Draw the belly in. The weight into your finger pads takes the weight of your body as your feet start to float up. And then once they float, get more active in the hamstrings, draw the heels towards your bum, round the upper spine as you look forward. Maybe your feet are floating, maybe they're not. Find your balance, get steady. And then the next breath in, draw the belly in strong. As you exhale, walk, step or hop back, Chaturanga Dandasana. Take your back bend. Cobra Upward Dog feels really good here. Extra Chaturanga if you like. And then all the way back, Downward Dog. Take a breath in, everyone. Full breath in. And a full breath out. Again, some options here to work into the hamstrings. On your inhale, sweep your right leg back behind you. As you exhale, right knee to right upper arm. Stay here. Maybe Chaturanga arms. Extend your right leg out to the right. Float your back toes. Kundanyasana A-B. Inhale. Sweep your right leg back behind you. This time as you exhale, bring your right knee to your left upper arm. You can hold on to your knee. Maybe you hold on to the inside of your foot or the outside and try to pull your foot back behind you. You can also do fallen triangle. And if you can, holding on to that foot, sweep it back behind you. Turn, look under your arm, finding that split in the legs. And then on your inhale, sweep it back up. Exhale, knee to chest. Keep coming forward, step through. Find Virabhadrasana 2 again. Front heel to back arch alignment. Just for a breath, extend. Deepen as you exhale. On your inhale, straighten the legs. Palms touch if you like, look up. Maybe even close your eyes. Exhale, bend in. Two more. Inhale. Exhale. Really nice. Inhale. And exhale. Keep your arms extended. Inhale your front leg to straight. Heel toe your back foot in just a little bit. When you're ready, hinge forward over your front thigh. Keep reaching. Try not to collapse. And then pivot your arms, finding Trikonasana. Right fingertips down, left hand reaching up. Be light onto that right hand, you can always use a block. If you have the big toe lock, wrapping your peace fingers around the big toe, spinning your chest open, looking up toward your top hand, finding that opening through the heart, extending the fingertips, these little branches of the heart, reaching out. And looking down, left hand to left hip, you may need a block under your right hand. Step off of your back foot. Try to keep your right fingertips light wherever they are, maybe floating. Find Ardha Chandrasana. And as you're here, try to spin your chest open. Maybe you reach your left hand up toward the ceiling. And an option here to get into the front of the left thigh. Bend your knee. You might need to bend both knees to get it and maybe even bring the knee in toward your chest. Wrap your hand around the outer edge of your foot and kick your foot into your palm as if you were doing the standing splits here, but that top knee is bent. There's still that deep opening into the inner thighs. Finding Japasana. Whatever your variation, if you can, be light onto your right hand. Keep your chest open. And then we'll make our way back. Some days your balance is better than others. Make your way back, standing L-shaped pose. So plug your right thumb into your hip crease. You might need to bend your right knee a lot. You'll find that opening. And here we'll take standing splits. So variation of Hanuman. Walking your hands toward your standing leg. Wrapping your right hand behind your right calf. Pull up onto it. And you can stay here with this L-shape. Or maybe start to pull your forehead toward your shin. And you'll notice that the top leg lifts higher. And try to drive your heel up toward the ceiling like we did at the beginning of the class. Press out through your heel, curling your toes toward you. Activate the front of your left thigh. And as you inhale, come back through center, soften into your right knee. Bring your left knee in to meet your chest. And with the power of your foot pressing down, stand all the way up. Bringing your left knee with you into your chest. And from here, you can hold on to your knee You can take big toe lock or take your hand on the outside of your foot. And I'll just step back to make sure I'm in the frame of the camera. I'm holding onto the outer edge of your foot, your big toe or your knee. You can inhale here, and as you exhale, extend that leg. That same L-shaped pose. Maybe you reach your right arm up. Now see if you can keep your hip down, but lift that leg higher, working in to more of a Hanuman shape. And maybe you open it up. Uttita Hasta Padangusthasana. Pull your outer left hip down, but drive the heel up. Maybe you gaze straight ahead or look over your right shoulder. Wherever you are, get steady. Feel connected through your standing foot. Take one more deep inhale here. Stay for your exhale. And then come back through center, reach your arms up to the sky, bend your knee. And we'll transition through Virabhadrasana 3, Warrior 3. Super slow motion, arms come forward, left heel drives back. And then step all the way to the back of your mat and open up to the long edge, the left edge. Hands to your hips. Roll your shoulders back, lift your chest. And as you exhale, hinge and fold. Bring your palms underneath your shoulders. Come to a halfway lift as you lengthen. As you exhale, bow in. Prasarita Padottanasana. Let your head come down, your hips lift up. So some different variations here. We will have a second set. So you can consider that whatever you do in the second set might be different than the first set. For this set, if you like, focus on getting the crown of your head down between your feet. If you have Shirshasana B in your practice, you can go for that. If you'd like to do something different, maybe a shoulder opener, or maybe wrapping the hands around the outer edges of your feet or even your big toes, pulling yourself in. And if you have Shirshasana, the elbows are pushing back and hugging in toward each other, bending around 90 degrees. Slowly the legs with control float up and squeeze together. Keeping the core strong. Try to relax your shoulders. When you're ready to come down, try to flex the feet, the ankles, the heels come down before the toes. Take one more round of breath wherever you are. And then coming to a halfway lift, inhale. As you exhale, turn toward the front of your mat. Now we'll work into Ardha Hanuman and Hanuman. Taking your left knee as far back as you can, feel free to roll your mat up on the long edge and stick one little bit extra underneath your knee if you need, or you can always use a block, a soft block if you have one. Anjaneyasana. This pose is a dedication to Hanuman's mom, who was praying for a beautiful child, and this was the position in which she prayed, and it was dropped down into her heart. And bending deeper into that right knee, hips are coming forward and down. If you're more interested in Hanuman stories, make a connection with me and I'll share some stories with you. Take an inhale, reach up, bend a little deeper. And one more breath in. This time as you exhale, like the wings of a bird, sweep your fingertips back behind you. See if you can float them as you bow forward over your front thigh. Then on your inhale, come back up through Anjaneyasana. Maybe have a little back bend. As you exhale, hinge back, float those arms. Press out through your heel, toes curl towards you. Good, one more. You're really activating the hamstring this way. Reach up, and you have to have that control through your core. Exhale, pull it back, and this time we'll hold. If you want to work toward another variation of Ardha Hanuman or Hanuman, bring your hands underneath your shoulders. You can use blocks if you like. Try to wiggle your right heel a little bit more forward so your left hip is over your knee. Take a breath in here, press the heel forward, toes towards you, and bow in. If you would like to go further, you can keep wiggling your right heel more forward, left knee more back, and for some people, it's helpful to take a block under that front thigh, and you can even be up higher if you like. Or for those of you going deeper, keep pulling your right hip back, left thigh forward, until you have that extension through both legs. And then any of those variations, if you like, you can bow in. Bowing in with bhakti, with devotion. And take a few deep breaths. Slowly we'll start to rise up, coming out of your deeper variation if you need. Slide your left knee more forward until you can bend your right knee and plant your foot down. Everybody coming to a lunge position, palms under shoulders, lift your back knee up. Take an inhale breath as you sweep your right leg back behind you. And here again, stack your hip, bend your knee. You can stay here or turn your left fingertips more to the left. Deweight your right hand, slow motion, flip over into wild thing. If you're working with that, or Urdhva Dhanurasana. Both feet parallel, spinning your chest open and reaching your right hand toward the floor. Wherever you are, either in Wild Thing or Urdhva Dhanurasana, open your chest, big breath in, stay for your breath out. And without collapsing, press into your left hand. Spin yourself all the way back around, right leg reaches up, ripple forward, high plank with your leg lifted, if you like, chaturanga. Move through your vinyasa, breathing deeply, staying connected, unwavering devotion to your practice. Big full breath in, big full breath out. Inhale, left leg lifts to the sky. As you exhale, left knee, left upper arm. Stay here, or chaturanga arms, try to make that same split shape that we started with, maybe right toes float, kundanyasana B. Inhale, sweep it back up. As you exhale, cross to the right side, turn to the side, hug onto your knee, your outer foot, maybe your big toe, and sweep your leg toward the top left corner of your mat, look under your arm. Amazing, inhale, sweep it back up. Knee in toward the chest. Keep coming forward as you step through. Back heel spins down. Virabhadrasana 2. Get deep into that posture right away, that devotion, that call to action. On your inhale, both hands reach up, straighten your front leg. Maybe look up and close your eyes. Exhale, warrior 2. Two more with the breath. Ujjayi breath in. Ujjayi breath out. Inhale. Exhale. Arms stay where they are. Straighten your front leg. Heel toe your back foot in just a little bit. Still find that front heel to back arch alignment. Start to hinge forward over your front thigh. Without collapsing, hold on to the reach. Keep reaching. And then pivot your arms. And if you need, you can always use a block on the inside or outside of your front foot. If you have that Padangusasana grip, wrap your peace fingers around your big toe. Pull your outer left hip underneath you, inner right thigh rolling open. Maybe you can gaze up to your top hand. Pull your heart apart. And gazing down to your left hand. Release your grip if you have it. Soften your left knee. We're going to be stepping forward off of our back foot. Ardha Chandrasana. You can take a block underneath your left hand if you need. Try to be light, even if you're using the block, just there for balance. Spinning your hip open, pressing out through your top heel. Maybe you reach your top arm up. Maybe some people can even look up. And then from here, soften your knees. Maybe you bring your right knee in toward you so you can catch the outer edge of your right foot. And then as you kick that foot back into your hand, creating that same sensation, the inner thighs that we get in Hanuman, turning your chest open. And maybe as you kick into your hand, you can float those left fingertips. As you're ready to release, both hands come down. Soften your left knee a lot so you can make this transition smooth for yourself, finding standing L-shaped pose. Left hand, maybe fingers, thumb, what I mean, comes into the hip crease. and driving that right heel back, that same shape we made at the beginning of the class. And then from here, starting to walk toward your standing leg, wrapping your left hand behind your calf. And as you pull up on the calf, try to bow your forehead in, and you'll notice there's more space for your right leg to lift higher. Might feel different on one side than the other. Try to relax your left shoulder. Let the head be heavy. Drive that right heel up. And then as you're ready, soften your left knee. Right knee comes in to meet it. It takes a lot of control to stand up here. So take your time. There's no rush. Keeping your right knee in towards your chest, find your balance. Left hand on your left hip to start. From here, hold on to the front of your knee, behind your knee, big toe lock, Padangusthasana, or outer edge of your foot as we did at the start of the class, any of those choices. Stand up tall, and when you're ready, extend that leg to any degree. And try to keep your hip down, but maybe pull the foot up a little higher, more like the Hanuman shape. Left arm comes up, and when you're ready, open it up. Uttita Hasta Padangusthasana, and again, that heel lifting, hip down. And maybe as you're ready, turning your gaze over your left hand. Beautiful, come back through center, that same dedication and loyalty. Virabhadrasana 3. And step all the way back and open up to the long edge of your mat. And I'm just going to turn this way so you can see me. So I'll just practice going to the other side for the remainder of the class. Again, hands to your hips, take a breath in. And as you breathe out, hinge and fold forward. And you can take a moment here, maybe a shoulder opener, maybe the hands coming down and the chest lifting. If you'd like to come with me, Samukhanasana, wide-legged splits pose, something I've been working on for a long time. Never seems to get any easier. So you can start by bringing your hands down. If you like, you can stay in the Prasarita Padottanasana variation. If you are coming with me, try to separate your feet as wide as you can. Maybe you stay on your palms. Maybe you can come down to your forearms. If you're quite deep into it and you find that keeping the inner edges of your feet down is sensitive for your knees, try turning your heels up, or sorry, pressing your heels out and turning your toes up. And this will get you probably a little bit more depth and less pressure on the knees. And wherever you are, take some deep breaths. We'll start to walk our way back up into the original position of the legs, wide apart. I'm going to switch myself here, and then we'll turn ourselves to the front of the mat. And this time you'll be lowering your right knee down, sliding your right knee as far back behind you as you can, coming onto your fingertips, and then making your way into Anjaneyasana, this pose of devotion of Hanuman's mother, who was gifted Hanuman from the god of wind, Vayu, dropped a seed into her heart, and that became Hanuman. Pulling your left hip back, right thigh forward, deep and into your lunge. Take a full breath here. Feel that connection to your own devotion, your own dedication, who it is that you send love and kindness from your heart toward. Inhale, and as you exhale, let's sweep the hands back behind us. That more buoyant variation of Hanuman, that connection to the wind, to Vayu. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, pull it back. Pressing the heel out. One more inhale. And exhale. You're welcome to stay here. If you want to work into a different variation of Hanuman, the more traditional variation, Hands can come down under your shoulders, but try to wiggle your left toes more forward so your right knee is over your hip. And again, you can use a block. Even if you're in this beginning of the pose, you can stay right here, working with Ardha Hanuman. If you're working toward more full variation of Hanuman, sliding your left heel more forward, right knee more back, but keep that sensation of left hip pulling back, right thigh forward. Again, the block can be underneath your left thigh. And once you're steady, you can stay up for a moment or start to bow in. I didn't say this on the other side, but sometimes it's helpful to keep your back toes tucked, and this will orient the back hip more forward. So if you're still working with that, try to keep the toes tucked. And bow in devotion. Thinking of those that you love, that you're sending this energy to. Beginning with yourself. Knowing that when you're called to action, that you can rise and act. There's no hesitation. You have the courage. You have the devotion. You have the loyalty. Slowly we'll start to rise up, bringing hands underneath the shoulders. If you're deeper into the posture, bring your right knee forward until you can plant your left toes down. Palms underneath the shoulders, lift your right knee up, and when you're ready, sweep your left leg back behind you. Start to stack your hip, bend your knee, let your foot drop behind. And then if you want to flip over, turn your right fingertips more to the right. Deweight your left hand, try not to go too fast here. Enjoy the slow motion. Finding wild thing or stepping your feet together, hip distance apart, and working to spin the chest open and keep coming down until your left hand reaches all the way down, Urdhva Dhanurasana. Take one more full breath here, either variation, lifting the heart up, and then using the strong right arm, spin yourself all the way back around, three-legged dog. Take your vinyasa. Perfect time to do an extra chaturanga. And then we'll make our way back, downward facing dog. From here, take a full deep ujjayi breath in. A full deep ujjayi breath out. On your next inhale, come high in your toes, bend your knees, look forward. We'll hop through to our seat. If you have a hop through with straight legs, you can go for that. You can watch me if you've never practiced. Worth working for. And land on your bum. Get your legs out in front of you. Paschimottanasana, one of my favorite stretches. Move the flesh around your seat from side to side. Sit up nice and tall. If you need to, you can always put something soft under your knees or even sit on the edge of a block. On your inhale breath, reach your arms up to the sky. Try to arch back a little bit. Make a bit of a Y shape with your upper body. And then exhale, fold in. Inhale, lengthen, nice flat back, heels forward, toes towards you, and then release. And you can take different variations here. Sometimes it's nice to release the wrist if you can get it to bring one hand underneath your feet and then grab with the opposite wrist for a few breaths. Try to traction the wrist bones away from each other. Maybe you're holding outer edges of your feet. Maybe your hands are soft and surrendering. Last full deep breath here. Stay for your exhale. And slowly roll yourself all the way up, all the way up, all the way up. And from here, we'll turn to the side of our mat and open the legs wide. Upavishta Konasana. So again, another variation of splitting the legs apart and getting that symmetry down the center line. And from here, we'll start with a side stretch. Take your right forearm to the right shin or inside of your right leg, left hand to your left hip. Start to spin your chest open. Keep both heels active, pressing out your left buttock, especially pressing down. On your inhale breath, sweep your top arm over, and as you exhale,
reach your fingertips toward the right, and maybe you spin your pinky down, thumb up. Maybe you're higher up, that's okay too. Maybe you can find your right hand to wrap around the outer right foot, left hand on top, and spinning the chest, looking underneath your arm. And stay active through the heels pressing out so you still feel that same stretch through the hamstring and the addition of the inner groin. And rise all the way back up. And we'll go to the left side, left hand, left arm to your leg, inside or on top. Right hand to your right hip, spin your chest open, keep your heels pressing out. Inhale your right arm up and over your ear. Parsva Upavishta Konasana. Some of these Sanskrit terms are tongue twisters. Left hand around the outer foot, right hand maybe on top. Spin your chest open. Try not to squish yourself into this shape, so remain spacious and open. Pressing out through those heels, back of your legs lengthening, inner thighs lengthening. And then we rise all the way up. Reach your arms up to the sky. And if you like, you can adjust a little bit to widen the heels if they've come together. And then as you exhale, hinge and fold. And you might need fingertips back behind you just to keep length in the spine. Maybe you can hold on to your shins. Maybe you can walk your hands to the inside of your feet and pull your heart down. And maybe turn your gaze to one side for a few breaths, other side for a few breaths. Doesn't matter where you are, as long as you're feeling it on the inside of your legs, you might be right up here. And over time, through dedication, through loyalty, through devotion to your practice, this bhakti that we infuse into our practice, this love for ourselves, the love for this practice, eventually we can go deeper. But as you progress, you accept the level where you are, you accept yourself as you are, and that's when openness happens. And slowly use your hands under your shoulders, push yourself back up. Hold behind your legs, bring them together. You can turn toward the front of your mat if you like. Widen your feet, do a few windshield wipers. You can stay as you are as well, if that works for you. We'll make our way down onto our back. So wiggle yourself toward the front of your mat if you're not there already. Fingertips reaching forward. Core is engaged. Take a breath in. And as you exhale, slowly lower down onto your back. Using core strength or holding onto your knees or behind your thighs if you need. Come all the way down. Walking your feet underneath your knees, hip distance apart. Arms tight into the body. So you can even shrug your shoulder blades together a little bit. And the very outer edges of your heels, maybe you can touch them with your fingertips, but try to hug your feet in so they're not wider than your hands, right beside your hips. On your inhale breath, as your shoulders squeeze slightly together, back of your head down, palms are flat. Inhale, lift your hips. Setu Bandhasana. Interlace your hands like we did at the beginning of the class, tight together. Squeeze your knuckles towards your heels. Lift the chest a little higher. You can stay here. You want to go one step further, release your hands beside your ears, elbows pointing up toward the ceiling. Come on to the crown of your head, maybe widen your hands, and then come all the way up. Urdhva Dhanurasana. Trying to straighten your arms and legs the best you can. Almost as if you could look back to your heels. Whichever variation you're in for the back bend, take a few more deep breaths. Try to stay in it. We'll just do one today. When you're ready to release, if you're in Urdhva Dhanurasana, you'll come slowly to your crown and make your way through bridge pose. For bridge pose, release your hands. Lift up a little higher with your last breath in. And then as you breathe out, slowly lower down. Let your feet come wide, inner knees touch. Bring your hands onto your body, one touching your heart, one touching your belly. Feel that connection to yourself.
that deep connection, that deep devotion. Now open your arms either in a cactus or a T shape. Let both of your knees drop to the right side. You might want to wiggle your hips a little bit to the left. Maybe you even slide your left foot more to the left so your knee and hip are in the same line. Maybe you place your right ankle on your outer left knee. You can turn and gaze away from your knees to the left side. Feel that outer left thigh being pulled down. Take some releasing breaths here. Maybe some sighs come out your mouth. That energy that we need to let go of so that we can feel that deeper connection to ourselves and to one another. Bringing your gaze back through center, release your top foot. Realign your hips so they're more in the center and keep your feet wide. This time we'll drop knees to the left. Maybe your hips adjust a bit to the right. You can also wiggle your right toes more out to the right, placing your left ankle on top of your outer right thigh. Let the knees drop down and maybe you turn your gaze to the right. Bringing your gaze back through center, releasing your foot, realign your hips. From here, you can hug your knees in towards your chest. Give yourself a nice squeeze, maybe a rock side to side. If there's any last pose that you would like to do today, maybe a happy baby, maybe even a mild inversion, you can. And then when you're ready, take your time to end in Shavasana. Let this be continuous for as long as you like. I'll leave you to set yourself up that way to enjoy it for as long as you can. Thank you so much for joining me for this practice. It's always an honor and a privilege to share the teachings of yoga. Hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Namaste.